Okay, pleasant afternoon, everybody. Pleasant afternoon to everybody. Welcome to our reading class today. It's July 16, 2024. Okay, and I am happy to see 18 participants with me this afternoon. So again, welcome to our reading class this afternoon. Last meeting, I think I said that I'll be giving a test today, but I will not proceed with that today because we need to quote to finish reading chapter 4, but we will be having a primer activity. So please, I want everybody to prepare a pencil or a ballpen, then prepare a notebook or a paper with you. This test, it will not be in the Google form, but this will be an in-class quiz for this afternoon. It will be a vocabulary test. So I'll be giving the class maybe 2 to 3 minutes to scan your notes about the vocabulary words that we discussed. I hope everyone is jotting down notes or paying attention with the words that I gave you for you to study. I'll just be giving items 1 to 8. It's only an 8-item test. Again, it's only an 8-item test for vocabulary. Again, that is for vocabulary. And so that it will be easy for you, you can also have chapter 5 with you.
Sorry, Miss Elaine.
Oh yeah, it's not chapter 5, but chapter 4. It's okay, Aaron.
Thank you, Miss.
Again, I'll be saying this for those who came in late. The quiz for today will not be in the Google and will not be in Google form, but it will be an in-class quiz. So it will be a vocabulary quiz, numbers 1 to 8. I want you to recall, to read through your notes, and I appreciate those who are writing down. I am requesting everybody to please open their camera. You can just open your camera. Okay, time check. It's already 5:08. Okay, two more minutes. Please review your notes. Review your notes, please. Vocabulary words. Okay, I hope everybody is ready now. Okay, put your pencils or your ball pens up, please, for me to get notified that everybody is ready. Thank you, Alfonso. Yes, Clara, thank you.
Wait, but I'm taking my paper and pen, okay? Just wait.
Okay, go, Mark. Okay, number one.
Wait, not enough. Please, I'm just finding my paper and pen.
Yes, go, Mark, go. Are you ready now? Ready, Mars? Okay, number one.
Okay. I'm already done taking the paper and the pen.
Okay, number one, what vocabulary word means it is an object made to resemble a human figure set up to scare birds away from field where crops are growing? What do you call an object made to resemble a human figure set up to scare birds away from a field where crops are growing? We can usually find this in at the farm, especially where rice and corn are growing. What do you call that one?
is number one? I'm not hearing it.
My voice is very soft, Alfonso. Or is it okay?
That's okay.
It's okay. Aaron, I'll be saying it again. It is an object made to resemble a human figure set up to scare birds away from a field where crops are growing. We can usually see it at the farm, especially where rice and corn are planted.
And then write the answer in the paper, right?
Yes, Mark.
So, and the answer is?
No, you don't have.
Write the paper. I'm not here again, miss.
Mark, you don't have to say the answer because this is an in-class quiz and I'll be getting your answers later on, okay?
Okay.
Because teacher will be recording your score. Aaron, you don't have to write everything that I'm saying. You just give me the vocabulary word, okay? What word is that one? Alfonso, do you know the answer?
Can you repeat again the question?
An object made to resemble a human figure set up to scare birds away from a field where crops are growing. We can usually see this at the field. It's used to scare animals or insects from eating the crops. Okay, number two, it means amazing. It means amazing. What word is that? It means amazing. Okay, next, number three, what word means stop working? Okay, it's a person who stopped working or the act of stopping to work.
I'm kind of confused, but I answered on the paper.
Number three, what do you call it? Means stop working. You know, but if you have a copy of the vocabulary words, this will be very easy for you. Number four, it means dare to do something. Dare to do something. It's okay if you scan your note as long as you have a copy of it. Dare to do something.
Since there are gonna be only five numbers.
Eight vocabulary words.
Okay.
Number five. What? Give me other term for stealing or getting things that are not yours. Give me another term for stealing or getting things that are not yours. That is number five.
Which one was number five again?
Number five is stealing or getting things not yours. Stealing or getting things that are not yours.
Pakai bajumu.
Let's move to number six. Number six now. Number six is what word means fair or fairness? Fair.
What? Number six?
Number six, it means fair. Fair or fairness. Okay, number seven. Number seven, what vocabulary word relates to young people? Or it means relating to young people. Relating to young people. What word is that? Number eight. Number eight, it means to provoke or to annoy. To provoke or to annoy.
What is number seven?
Nice, I have done everything, but not number five. It's hardness.
Number five, Nicolas, meaning stealing or getting things that are not yours. Aaron, what are you saying, Aaron?
Miss.
Yes, Mariana.
Can you replay a question? Number six.
Number six, Mariana, is it means fair. Fair.
Miss?
Yes, Clara.
Can you repeat number seven?
Number seven, relating to young people. Relating to young people.
Miss?
Yes, Josephine.
Can you replay the question number eight?
Okay, number eight. It means provoke or annoy. To provoke or annoy. It's the last vocabulary word that I gave last meeting. If you have your notes with you.
Oh, Miss?
Yes.
Can you repeat number five?
Okay, and the number five. Oh, number five means stealing or getting things that are not yours. stealing or getting things that are not yours.
Yes, sir, but I don't know the answer of number 5.
Okay, if you don't know. Maybe you can think of something that, you know, because I'll be checking your score, your answers.
Yes, I took all my vocabulary words. If nothing equals to stealing or something that's not yours.
Remember, what did the little boy do? What is the little boy doing in the story? That's the answer for number 5. Okay, number 9. Number 9. Number 9, everybody. What season? Okay, what season was being celebrated in the story?
What, Miss?
What season or what celebration was mentioned in the story? Why are they going to church? Why are they preparing food? What's the season or what celebration was it? Okay, for last number, number 10. Okay, number 10. Give me
number 9. Yes.
Oh, wait, okay, number 9 is what celebration or what occasion was mentioned in the story? That's number 9. Then for number 10, you just give me one character that you can find in the story or that you know from our story. Give me one character that you know from the story. Okay, so that's it. Okay, that's the quiz for today. I'll be waiting for the responses. Could you please take a photo of it, then send it in my WhatsApp number. Okay, in the chat box, you have my WhatsApp number so you can send your answers, the picture of your answers. Okay, I'll be waiting maybe for 2 minutes for you to do it. But if you can't do it now because your mother is not yet here, you can just send it later. Noel, hope you can help Nicolas. Noel?
Yes, miss.
Please help Nicolas in sending the answers.
Okay, miss.
Okay. Then I'll be recording here on my notes who will be the first one to send their answers. So there are 22 participants. I am expecting 22 messages this time. You know what? This is a TOEIC class, but there are Perlini is here, Felicia is also here, and Yessa is also here. Zuby is not here. Ah, okay. Zuby is not here. Okay, I'll wait for two minutes for you to take a pic, to take a photo, then send it and my WhatsApp number. Then we will continue our discussion.
Miss, can you repeat number six?
Number six, honey.
Yes.
Okay, number six, me. What word means fair? Fair.
Right. Thank you, Miss.
Welcome.
Mau nanya.
Okay, I received Mariana's answer. Next to Mariana, I have, oh. I'm sorry, Tristan, but I cannot do it, Tristan. Okay, Noel, I already got your answer. Hey, Clara, thank you also, Clara.
Miss, number
Yes.
six is fair or fair?
Come again, Pharrell.
Number six is fair or fair?
Fair, fair. Not fair. Fair is different from fair. Oh, maybe some of you are searching the answers in the Google. Okay, do it fast. Okay, thank you, honey.
Miss, I'm about to send a clue.
Yes, I already have your answer, Nicolas. Wow, that's good. Oh, I'm very happy.
But sorry, Miss, I didn't do number five.
You did not do number five. I'll just, what do you call that one? I'll reply with that one so that you will know what's number five.
Halo. Paham enggak?
Okay, so far I have Mariana, then I have Noel, Clara, Honey, and Nicolas. Okay, I also have Catherine now. Oh, Catherine, what happened to the first five? Okay, and let me check.
Yes.
Yes, yes.
By the way, what's the answer to number five?
I already responded, but I will not say it here because there are still kids who have not yet sent their answers. I am checking it right now. By the way, you got 9 out of 10. Well, Noel got a perfect score. Okay, very good, honey. You got a good score, honey.
Thank you, Rin.
Yeah, very good. Alfonso, I haven't received yours. Mariana, very good. Can you guess your score, Mariana?
I don't know.
What? Do you know that you got a perfect score? That's good.
Thank you, Miss.
Thank you. Very, very good. Sundara, thank you also, Sundara.
Thank you, teacher.
Yeah. Josephine.
Yes, miss.
Are you not sure with
yes,
your
miss.
Answers? Are you not sure with your answers, Josephine?
Yes, miss.
Can you guess what the score is?
Maybe it's not too good.
But you know what? For a while. Can you check your WhatsApp? What's your score? Okay, so far I got 10 responses from the class. How about Celesta? How about Yessa? Okay, I hope other kids will find time later on to send their answers. So by this time, I am already sharing my screen because we'll be finishing chapter 4 tonight. So just a short recap. It's Christmas Day. I mean, it's Christmas Eve. Mrs. Joe Gargery, the brother-in-law of the little boy in the story, they are celebrating Christmas Eve, and they are entertaining visitors with them. So who are the visitors to their households? You have Mrs. Wopsle, together with Uncle Pambo, took soil. They visited the Gargery's home. If you can still recall last time, I have asked you the question, what things are you grateful for? And many of you shared to me and to everyone that they are grateful for their families. They are grateful for their life. You are grateful for, you know, having the chance and the opportunity to study, to eat, and to play. So there are many things that we should be grateful for. Okay. So why are we discussing that one? Because here in the story, so Mr. Pambochuk said that today's generation of kids are not that grateful. Okay, you have that in line 125. So he was asking, why is it that the young are never grateful? Why is it that the young are never grateful? It's somehow he is, what do you call that one? He is comparing the younger generations compared to the past generations, that he can see the difference, that the new ones are not grateful for everything that they have. So just like what I keep on saying to you, we should always be grateful no matter how big or small we have or everything or what we enjoy. So let's all be grateful. So we have finished that part. Let us continue in here. So finish that one. So while they are talking that one, while they are talking, the little boy in the story said, oh, why am I put in this situation? Everything that's within me are, or surrounding me are already mature people. And they're talking about that. But there's only one person who keeps on, you know, keeping the situation light. And that is Mr. Joe. Okay, what is Mr. Joe doing? He was the one who gave food to the boy, then telling the boy, oh, you don't have to be worried because I am here, I'll be helping you. So that is what the story is, you know, what is the story is working on now. So you have it here, Joe offered me more gravy, which I was afraid to take. Okay, so we are finished with this one. Oh. So we are almost finished with chapter 4. I think we're also done with this. Okay. Let us start with this one. Lines 191. Josephine, I'll have you first.
Yes, miss. Okay, miss. Have a little brandy, uncle, said my sister. Oh, heavens, it had come at last. He would find it was weak. He would say it was weak. And I was lost. I held tight to the leg of the table under the cloak with both hands and awaited my fate.
Okay, so the sister was handing what kind of drink, Josephine?
What, miss?
The sister was handing what kind of drink? She is letting the uncle drink. Okay. So the sister was saying, oh, uncle, please have a little brandy. Okay. Brandy, as discussed previously, it's an alcoholic drink. So since it's an alcoholic drink, do kids allow to drink it? Is it safe for kids? Yes, it's a big no. Kids are not safe to drink brandy. So who are, what do you call that one? who will be the one to drink the brandy? Who can just drink the brandy? Those who are? Your fathers or our fathers can drink. Those in the right age, they can drink brandy. Okay, so again, brandy, it's an alcoholic drink. Okay, honey, this one is for you.
Okay, miss. My sister went for the stone bottle. Come back with the stone bottle and poured his brandy out. No one else taking any. The worst man traveled with his glass. Took it up. Look at it, through the light. Put it down. Relish my misery. All this time, Mrs. Joe and Joe were briskly clearing the table for the pie and pudding.
Okay, so you can clearly say that there are many foods being prepared for that night. So the brandy, where was the brandy being stored? It's stored on the stone bottle. Okay, so while the boys are drinking brandy, Mr. and Mrs. Joe were briskly clearing the table for pie and pudding. Okay, this time, please take down your notes. So you have brandy first, then you have briskly. Okay, let us, what do you call that one? Let's give the definition of briskly. Okay, when you say briskly, that means being active or quick. Okay, active or quick. I think I have to write it here. Okay, so you have it here. All this time, Mrs. Joe and Joe were briskly. When you say briskly, they're very quick. They are moving quickly to clear the table, ready for the pie and the pudding. Mariana, this one is for you.
What, miss?
Yeah, this one.
I couldn't keep my eyes off him, always holding tight by the leg of the table with my hands and feet. I saw the miserable creature finger his glass playfully, take it up, smile, throw his head back, and drink the brandy off. Instantly, afterwards, the company were seized with unspeakable consternation owing to his peering to his feet, turning around several times in an appealing spasm. Whooping confidence and rushing out at the door. He then become visible through the window. Filthy, fluing, and expectorating, making the most hideous faces and apparently out of his mind.
Okay, how do you read this word?
Seized.
So this one is seize. Seize. This one. Mariana, it's appalling. This one.
Miss. Miss.
Yes, yes.
Miss, I'm going to the toilet.
Yes, can see. Okay. I will be highlighting difficult words to pronounce in the sentence in the paragraph. Okay, please listen. This one is seize, seize. This one, springing, springing. Violently, violently. Longing, longing. Hideous, hideous. This one, miserable creature, miserable creature. Noel, could you please read again this paragraph, Noel? Well, okay, Noel is no longer here. How about Alfonso? Can you read it now?
Okay, miss. I couldn't keep my eye from off him, always holding tight by the leg of the table with my hands and feet. I saw the miserable creature finger his glass playfully, pick it up, smile, throw his head back, and drink the brandy off. Instantly afterwards, the company were seized with unspeakable consternation, owning his springing to his feet, turning round several times in an appalling spasmodic whooping call dance, and rushing out at the door. He then became visible through the window, violently longing and expectorating, making the most hideous face and apparently out in of his mind.
Okay, thank you, Alfonso.
Welcome.
Okay, I already got Alfonso's answer. Okay, I also have Farrell. Then I also have Felicia's answer. Okay, so what is meant by this paragraph? What is meant by this paragraph? So the little boy was still, you know, not in good state, because he was still thinking of the act that he had done the previous days. Excuse me. Oh, Dr. Harry is here.
Hello, teacher. Thank you so much. Thank you for your time. Hello, kid. Okay, I'm sorry. I did not put my cam on. I just stopped by. I'm about ready to go now. Keep it up. I'm so glad. Okay, now there is a good thing here. Okay, there's a new development just now. Okay, teacher Germaine. Okay, and also tell your student in the Philippines. Okay, now for those who study in STEM. Okay, STEM, science, technology. Okay, what is E? Tristan, what is E? Is it STEM.
AI? Is that AI?
STEM. Science. T stand for what? Josephine?
Yes, sir.
T stand for technology. E stand for what? Verlini. Engineering. Okay. All right. So there is a new law has been proposed. Whoever do the STEM, whoever do the STEM in the US, okay, can stay here in the US and to find job. Okay. So like Alfonso, okay, you want to be a doctor, okay? And also somebody else, Catherine, what you want to be? And Honey want to be a doctor, okay? Felicia want to be IT, according to her mom. Catherine mau jadi apa? Mau tanya mama dulu, mau jadi apa ya? Want to ask mom first, okay? So you can stay in the US, but you need to be STEM, STEM, okay? All right, so with that in mind, but first you have to know English, right? Okay, so teacher German here will help you. Okay, this is just a new thing, all right? Now, a lot of parents, at this, okay, 3 years ago, the same with Alfonso and Josephine, they said, now, wow, Alfonso can speak English. Josephine can speak English. Catherine can speak English. All right. Even when they talk with the kid, neighborhood kid, okay, sometimes Alfonso pop this English and speaking English, and the other kid say, what are you talking about? Okay. What language are you speaking about? Right, Alfonso? Is that correct? Okay. You see that? Okay, teacher German. They already speak in English, and I encourage them, okay, the kid, the TIS kid at school in Santa Lucia, if you meet each other, you speak in English. It is not to show off, but to make your English better, conversation, okay? So it is international now. Now, here is the thing. The neighborhood mom said, wow, Alfonso can speak English so well. You see that? Now, but the problem is this. They see the output. They see the result that Alfonso can speak English, but they did not want to see. They forgot that Alfonso is struggling in 3 years. Okay, Inda, keep that in mind. Inda, you and Honey, okay, in class 6, all right? When you meet at Santa Lucia and Alfonso, you can speak English. Okay, you have to speak English. Okay, and also Mariana, are you going to school now? You okay?
Yes, Mr.
Okay, so anybody can speak. Okay, Tristan. Okay, so I think some of these kids not okay. This semester you speak in English. Next semester, if you meet, you speak Mandarin. Honey and Inda can speak Mandarin. Okay? You already talk and speak two languages. But we put a target. Okay? In January, you speak in Mandarin. Okay? Now, this semester, you speak in English. Okay, teacher German, I think three more minutes. You know, I just so excited to see this kid. You know, they are growing. Oh, unimaginable.
Yes,
what
yes,
the future
sir.
Will be. And then we are looking forward for your Philippines teach, you know, kid, teacher German to come and join. Okay, thank you guys. I have to
yes,
leave,
sir.
Okay?
Thank you.
Keep it up. Keep it the good
bye-bye.
Work. Bye-bye. Bye-bye, everyone.
Thank you,
bye-bye.
Sir.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir.
Bye, sir.
Bye-bye.
Hey, everybody, that is Dr. Harry from the Tutors International School. Okay, so Sir Harry was talking about the STEM Actually, the Philippines is already adopting that one in here. It's one of the trucks being offered by the Ed Philippines. It's one of the trucks offered for senior high kids, because after junior high, they're going to move to after junior high, they're going to move to senior high. So you have STEM, that is science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, that goes along with GAS, with UMS, with TVL. So, you know, hearing those words from Dr. Harry, it's a privilege for you, Indonesian kids, to explore and, you know, get a chance to study abroad. So please continue learning English. Right, Alfonso? Do you find English interesting and helpful for you? Yes? Do you find English helpful?
Yes, miss.
Why do you say so? Because aside from being an international language, right, you can communicate with other people through English. Although there are many languages that you can use, but, you know, English is a universal language. Okay, before we end, Perlini is still here. Perlini?
Yes, miss.
Okay, before we end, what can I ask you something about why English is important for you, or why do we need to study English?
Okay, I will explain a simple things. When you watch an entertainment in TikTok, the example, and some English video come to your FYP, and you don't need any Google Translate anymore, and you just understand what video means.
Yes, exactly. You don't need to translate it, because you yourself can really understand what was being shown with you. Okay. Thank you so much, Perlini. And with that, I hope you are already, you know, inspired to learn English more. Okay. So thank you, everybody, for staying with me. I'll see you on Thursday for our reading class. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you, miss.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.